Hello!
Mr. Tarrou.
Okay.
I've done a lot of videos about vertical asymptotes, horizontal asymptotes, slant asymptotes, and on that slant asymptotes video, I ended up making a full graph, which from start to finish, and I want to do some more of that today with graphing rational functions. And first off, we're going to do y equals x minus 2 over x minus 3. Okay, so let's look for vertical asymptotes. Now, first thing you want to do with vertical asymptotes, that is like you, the questions were maybe in chapter 1 of your pre-calc book, where you were being asked what's the domain of the function. You can't divide by 0. So vertical asymptotes will occur most of the time when your denominator can be set equal to 0. So in this case, we have x minus 3 in the denominator. That cannot equal 0, which is also answering the domain of this graph. And that means that x cannot equal 3. So we are going to have a vertical asymptote for this rational function at x equals 3. Now, in the next example, you're going to see if you have a 0 in your denominator and it cancels out, that's actually going to make a whole. But otherwise, whenever that denominator can equal 0 and it cannot be canceled out, that is going to yield a vertical asymptote. Okay, horizontal asymptotes. Well, in my video about horizontal asymptotes, I showed you how you truly find them using limits. But then that broke down to a basic, three basic rules. If your top degree is larger, there is no horizontal asymptote. If your degree on the top and bottom is the same, it's going to be the leading coefficients of the top and the bottom, numerator and denominator. And if your bottom degree is larger, you're going to have a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0. Well, our numerator has a degree of 1, our denominator has a degree of 1, and since those degrees match, the horizontal asymptote is going to be y equals the leading coefficient of the top divided by the leading coefficient of the denominator, the bottom term. Polynomial. So that's going to be 1 over 1 or 1. So our horizontal asymptote, because the degree of the numerator equals the degree of the denominator, they're both 1, is going to be y equals 1. Okay, so we have vertical and horizontal asymptotes. Slant asymptotes, well, this doesn't have a slant asymptote because we already determined it has a horizontal one, but slant asymptotes occur when the top degree is larger by 1 compared to the bottom degree, and you find that using division. Or check out my other video. Well, what else has this thing got going on? What is the x-intercept? Well, the x-intercept, of course, is found by setting y equal to 0. So that's going to be 0 equals x minus 2 over x minus 3. Well, let's not forget about a fraction. How do you get a fraction equal 0? If the top is equal to 0, the entire fraction equals 0. If the bottom equals 0, well, then it's undefined. That was our question about vertical asymptotes. So when you deal with rational functions and you want to find out where it crosses the x-axis, you want to find out if you can find a place where it crosses the y-axis when y equals 0, then all you have to do is worry about the numerator. 0 equals x minus 2. And you get the same equation if you try to multiply both sides by x minus 3, it would disappear anyway. Add 2 to both sides, and my x-intercept is 2. Okay, what else can I figure out about this rational function? Well, let's see if we can find out what the y-intercept is. The y-intercept is when you let x equal 0, and that's usually a relatively easy number to find. It could be because of how easily usually the equation falls out. So the y-intercept, when you let x equal 0, is going to be the y-intercept is equal to 0 minus 2 over 0 minus 3. I'm just plugging 0 in for my x values. And negative 2/3 reduces, of course, to be positive 2/3. So my y-intercept is 2/3. Now, another thing to check, which would be nice for graphing, is this function even or is it odd? Let's plug in even or odd. You do that by plugging in negative x into your function and seeing if all the signs are the same or if all the signs are different. So we're going to write negative x minus 2 over negative x minus 3, and we get negative x minus 2 over negative x minus 3. Well, first of all, is it even? If my function, if I plug in negative x and I get right back to the original function, then it's even. Now, I don't have exactly the same function. I have some of the signs changed and some of them did not. Why would I care if the graph was even for sketching? If a function is even, it's symmetric to the y-axis. So in a sketch, if I make sure that the left side of the y-axis, did I just say it was symmetric to the x-axis? I hope not. Even functions are symmetric to the y-axis. So the left of the y-axis and the right of the y-axis would look the same. Well, not all my signs stayed the same. I don't have originally what I started off with, so it's not even. Why would I care if a function is odd? If it has 180 degree rotational symmetry, which a book would call symmetric to the origin, that would also make it a little bit better, a better sketch to see exactly what it would look like. Well, if it's an odd function, all of the signs change. Well, I have two of my signs changed, the ones in front of the x, but my constant sign stayed the same. So this function is neither even nor is it odd. So I think we're ready to try and draw a picture. So we have a graph with a vertical asymptote at 3, so we have a vertical asymptote at x equals 3, we have a horizontal asymptote at y equals 1, and the blue and yellow again are the asymptotes. And what do we have at this point? We've got our x-intercept is 2. We have our y-intercept is 2/3. And that's about it. So I might need to find a few more points. Now, you have the possibility of crossing a horizontal asymptote occasionally, but you'll never cross a vertical asymptote. So this graph is coming down through this point, and it's going to curve down towards negative infinity. I can do that by checking, let's say, x, y, let's say I could use a x value of 0.5 and plug it in here. But I know this is going to curve down, so I'm going to try like negative 1. And let's find out what happens to the right of the vertical asymptote. 1, 2, 3, let's try x values of 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so negative 1 minus 2 is negative 3, and negative 1 minus 3 is negative 4, so that comes out to be 3/4. So at negative 1, we're at, why did I do negative 1? Oh, at negative 1, we're at 3/4, so we're a little bit closer to 1, and this graph is going to taper off underneath the horizontal asymptote of y equals 1. It's just going to keep coming up closer to y equals 1 from the bottom. And then at 4, we have 4 minus 2, which is 2. 4 minus 3, which is 1. So that's 2. So at 4, we're at 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, we're at the y value of 2. At 5, and I think that might be all we need, at 5, we have 5 minus 2, which is 3. Over 5 minus 3, which is 2, and that's 1.5. So at 5, we're at 1.5, and this graph is going to continue to come down and get closer to to y equals 1 as x goes off to infinity. And as I get closer to the y, the vertical asymptote at x equals 3 is going to continue to go up to positive infinity. So there you go, the white part of this graph is the graph of y equals x minus 2 over x minus 3. So, graphing rational functions. Let's try and do one more. Okay, I'm not going to have time for one more, so let me go ahead and start a new video, go to the next part, and we're going to graph a rational function that has both a hole in it and a vertical asymptote. And don't forget, if you look up slant asymptotes, there is a complete graph of finding where, show you how to find that slant asymptote, find the x and y intercepts, do a couple of additional points and graph. So you will have three complete examples of graphing rational functions. All right, be back in a second.